Welcome everyone to Merton for this service of choral evensong. Information about the music for tonight's service can be found on pages 4 and 5 of the service booklets. The choir now sings the psalmody, Psalms 9 and 10 from the Book of Common Prayer, and we sit.
Thank you. The first lesson is written in the book Proverbs, chapter 4. Hear, my child, and accept my words, that the years of your life may be many. I have taught you the way of wisdom. I have led you in the paths of uprightness. When you walk, your step will not be hampered, and if you run, you will not stumble. Keep hold of instruction. Do not let go. Guard her, for she is your life. Do not enter the path of the wicked, and do not walk in the way of evildoers. Avoid it. Do not go on it. Turn away from it and pass on, for they cannot sleep unless they have done wrong. They are robbed of sleep unless they have made someone stumble. For they eat the bread of wickedness and drink the wine of violence. But the path of the righteous is like the light of dawn, which shines brighter and brighter until full day. The way of the wicked is like deep darkness. They do not know what they stumble over. My child, be attentive to my words. Incline your ear to my sayings. Do not let them escape from your sight. Keep them within your heart. For they are life to those who find them, and healing to all their flesh. Keep your heart with all vigilance, for from it flow the springs of life. Put away from your crooked speech, and put devious talk far from you. Let your eyes look directly forwards, and let your gaze be straight before you. Keep straight the path of your feet, and all your ways will be sure. Do not swerve to the right or to the left. Turn your foot away from evil. Here ends the first lesson.
Thank you. The second lesson is written in the Gospel, according to Matthew, chapter 5. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same, will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and the Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. Here ends the second lesson.
Thank you.
Words of tonight's anthem, See the Word is Incarnate, are written by Godfrey Goodman, set to music by Orlando Gibbons. Let us pray.
I have taught you the way of wisdom. Keep hold of instruction, do not let go. Guard her, for she is your life. Let us give thanks for the wisdom revealed to us in Christ, for the sacrificial love that puts God and not self at the center of life, for almighty power exercised in humble service, for the flicker of light that overcomes the deepest darkness, and for the wounded hands that reach out with healing and hope. So let us pray for ourselves and for all people that the pursuit of such wisdom may be the goal of our lives. Most high and glorious God, enlighten the darkness of our hearts and give us a true faith, a certain hope, and a perfect love. Give us a sense of the divine and knowledge of yourself, so that we may do everything in fulfillment of your holy will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus says, "Let your light shine before others." As Christ calls us to live lives that reflect his light, let us pray for those who this day have experienced the darkness of pain, despair, and bereavement. For all who feel abandoned by God, for all who lack human friendship and care. God of love, whose light brings wisdom, peace, and hope, cast away from all those who struggle the shadows of pain and suffering. Bring healing to the wounded, insight to the confused, and peace to the distressed. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In a moment of silence, let us offer to God our own prayers. We pray together in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore. Amen. We stand to sing the hymn on page 5 of the booklets, O Christ, the Word is incarnate.